they're not cool.
Variety of traditions. And some of the proposed
Hindu
foundation,
yeah.
I think,
that would be
huh?
But again,
examine everything.
To deny completely, to totally remove any
world bread,
that has come from India, it probably hurts a bit.
Can't
Hindus or Indians be proud that yoga's become such a big thing?
Suzanne?
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that the Hindu American Foundation has been using this as a kind of provocative subject to bring more awareness about Indians and their beliefs to America.
In Nelson, see?
Acceptably in schools without reference to any other ideology. But yoga was Hinduism.
Well, I also like to say there's this sort of idea that yoga in India has always been very spiritual and now it's been turned into this commercial crass modern. It's not.
Yeah, tell us how.
Because 15th century texts teach that by doing the practices correctly, all your grey hair will disappear and your wrinkles will disappear and you'll become very beautiful to the opposite sex and so forth. So some of them
are long yeah, long yeah.
Yeah, they're being told out. They're being told out, isn't it?
Missionaries complained about the yogis begging for money.
They're told, my love, they're told, you can't even tell them.
They're
being told.
There is always the element which is there, political, economic, whatever it is, which runs throughout all these traditions. It is not simply here is a text, here is a tradition, and therefore it's seen of all these things.
I want to ask each one of you.
Yeah, close up, we'll see.
We're going to be talking about it.
Because I gather you're
a practitioner.
If you had to give up,
there's a new